Hello everyone. Finally, with one day delay, I am ready to present you this very interesting topic of personal branding tactics and tricks for better audience engagement. First of all, let me introduce you myself with a few quick words. For people who didn't know me before, actually, I know many of the people inside this community are my friends for more than a year. But for who doesn't know me, I'm a specialist in coaching and consulting lead generation and closing, and actually help coaches, mentors, and consultants from wide range of fields to improve their efforts to build their audience, to engage with their potential clients, and to actually convert that leads into paying clients, especially in a one-to-many ways, the only reasonable way to grow your business. Actually, we are working mostly with people who are already started their coaching practices and who need some help and guidance in order to become fully authorized coaching and consulting businesses and to work on scaling up their coaching practices, because many people struggle on this setup. They have some unique experience, they have some unique abilities to help others, and they work one-on-one with few people, but they have difficulties to find more people and to engage them and to offer them group coaching, master classes, membership sites. Everything of these are our specialties. So now with personal branding, community management, and so on, I would like to discuss today some things that may look a little bit weird. But let me start with one of these things. First of all, we are not fully for organic growth. Of course, this is also our own strategy, and a lot of people work for their organic presence online, and they have significant success with this kind of efforts. But of course, if you want to have some consistency in your lead generation without spending timeless hundreds of hours of efforts in building your brand organically, we also help coaches and consultants use Facebook business manager and prepare some awesome Facebook and Instagram ads, optimize them, target the proper people, and from there on improve their metrics. So you have to pay in order to compress the time necessary to get your clients. But this is on the side for the moment. I'm not going to talk right now on this topic. I'm going to talk about the topic of community building, how you can do it fully organically the proper way, and then discuss how you have to structure your content building machine, how you have to present your content in front of your audience, and which are the most difficult and most important mistakes that you have to avoid with your with building your personal brand inside social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, LinkedIn, and so on. Of course, each platform have different personality and different strategies for it. And I'm going to talk right now mostly about Facebook, but the number one mistake most people do. Do you know what it is? Actually, the number one mistake people do, the number one mistake people make when they present their ideas in front of their audiences is to start talking a lot, sharing a lot of posts, a lot of written content, copywriting, a lot of videos, a lot of everything without asking people what they want. This is the number one mistake. This is something that everyone did at a given moment of time. I did this mistake multiple times. Of course, I know very well now that it's something that has to be avoided in most cases. So there's no point to post a lot of copywriting and content upfront before asking what your audience wants and need to read, to know, to listen, to watch. Actually, people have some specific interests. You have to know very well the people in your circle and the people who you want to serve with your specific capacity, and only then to present the content that they will interact with. Because you can reach a point when you literally saturate your community with content that they either don't like, or maybe they like, but they don't feel it's something unique, something they didn't know, and something interesting. So don't spend too much efforts in trying to build copywriting content for your audience unless you see the interaction of the people with this content and you see that people ask questions and are interested. Of course, at the beginning, if you start with a small community, then the interactions will not be able to be scaled up immediately, and you will have to post some content upfront without knowing exactly what people want. But even in this case, it's possible to make this happen with this one small trick. Actually, you prepare a survey. You request your audience, you tag the people you would like to know their opinion, and you prepare this survey. You can do it in Typeform, at SurveyMonkey, at other platforms that have the capacity to build small, not more than 10-15 questions. You prepare this small survey, ask people, and understand at the beginning what they initially want, and you try to post content as much in the same direction that these people are interested, in order to gain their attention and to try to start interacting with them. This is first tip number one. Then tip number two. You have a lot of people who want to use your community, Facebook group, or other social media platform to build their brand and their presence. Many Facebook group owners start to think that these people are their competition, and they are entering into their space and trying to capture their leads. Actually, this happens often, but there is no problem with this if you think a little bit more in depth. Actually, there are so many idiots, so many leads inside social media. There are too many hundreds of thousands of people who potentially can be interested of your special subject that you are working on. And if somebody steal one or two leads, that's not a big problem. Also, I promise you that most of these people are also very, very beginning level businesses who struggle with their leads, and that's why they try to organically capture somebody from your group. But it's totally okay for you if you flip the coin and see the other side of the coin. And actually, what is this other side? The other side is that these people bring some value to your community. They may present a content, a questions that people will interact. You can also join this discussion and start talking and discussing with these people, and they will be totally happy to interact with you because they see the benefits of you allowing them to present their content. Of course, not directly the offers they have, because that's not totally correct. But if they don't directly present their offers, they can freely share content, ideas, and many, many people will interact. So you will free some of your precious time for other valuable things to do. And of course, this is very good and important. Every single great community inside Facebook I know have a lot of engaged posters, a lot of engaged people who regularly discuss interesting topics. And if you like these people, if you want to engage them even further, you can raise their status as moderators of your community. This way, they will have even more reasons to stay in your community, to post valuable content, to interact with people. This is trick number two. I will post later in the comments below these ideas I am sharing here, but much better if you can listen and perceive what I'm talking right now inside this video. So this is trick number two for building engaging and very active dynamic community. That's why when you know the interest of the people and when you have some up-level participants that may accelerate the growth of the community and escalate the talks to a specific degree, then you can literally explode your organic presence inside social media. Then, tip number three, many people underestimate this tip, but it's very important. I'm not using very actively this trick inside my community, but I will use it in the future, and it's a little bit time consuming, but it can pay off tremendously. Try, and here's the tip, try to interact with as many people inside Facebook Messenger directly. If you see they fit a specific profile, for example, if you are a fitness coach and for example trainer for specific sport, and if you find people interested in fitness, interested in running another sport that you are engaged with, you know these people are potential targets for your business, potential customers. And that's why you ping them, you say them hello, share some valuable tips with them, make some fun and laugh interactions. If you succeed to exchange few words with them, and then after these few words, not immediately, not just copy-pasting the link to your group, but when you interact with these people for a while, for maybe few minutes, it's not necessary to be weeks or months. If you see they interact with you and they are open to communicate, then you bring them the link to your group and say, hey, you can find much more value on the topic we discussed. If you would like to participate in my Facebook group, we are sharing a lot of free stuff, a lot of valuable content every day, great community, many like-minded people. Just send them a link with this short explanation, and I ensure you that 85 to 90% of the people you interact will totally say, yes, of course, I'm eager to learn more. And then you bring them a link and they join your community. This way, even time intensive, it's totally free. It doesn't require any kind of advertising investment, and you gain more and more and more followers. But don't do it automatically, don't use chatbots, don't try to scam people, don't try to spam people, and also don't try to scam them. These are two very similar things. And if this strategy works, you can expand to more and more people that you initially find in a specific targeted groups in similar topics, then you send them friend requests, then you start engaging with them, and only then bringing your link to your Facebook group. And that's not the entire process. So after you bring these people to your Facebook group, on the questions for accepting their application for the group, you ask them for their email in exchange of something very valuable. This can be ebook, this can be some training, free training, this can be some tips list, but something that you are sure that will be highly valuable to these people. Then they won't resist to give you this email. For example, after I start building our community, we have over 300 people right now, not too much, but guess what? I have already close to 200 people inside my email list just from this Facebook group. No advertising, totally organic strategy for list building. I know people that build 4-5 figure email list just from their Facebook group. But you have to have this lead magnet very well presented. It should be something with immense value. I recommend, but of course this is probably a little bit more difficult to do, but I recommend, if you have the capacity, to present them full written ebook, detailed ebook with dozens, if not 100 page of content, totally specific to a given subject. This will be the irresistible offer for these people to bring you their email and to participate in your Facebook group. Then, this is trick number three. So, it was first, check your content, ask surveys, and find out what people are interested. Second, what was the second tip? Second tip, try to engage as many active posters as you can, and bring some of them to moderator's role, tip number two. And then find, personally engage and talk with targeted people in your niche, this is tip number three. Tip number three works only if you talk with people that are highly targeted to what you are going to present. If they are not very well aligned, if they are not in the very same thing you do, then it will dilute and will be much less important and much less value to your organic growth. These are the first three tips. Then tip number four, and here it comes the Facebook manager business ads account. You want to have people that you can target inside your business profile. How you target people? Everybody is talking about building lookalike audiences, building things that are bigger audiences, find specific terms and chase people who like somebody else, like Ty Lopez,